Good morning, student. Myself Chirag Sukhani, and I'm going to teach you elements of strategic management subject. And we will continue our chapter, that is industry analysis. Now, in earlier video, we discussed about the industry structure. Now, today in this session, we will discuss remaining two part, that is industry attractiveness and the industry performance. Yeah. Now, third is what? Third nature of the industry, that is industry attractiveness. Now, industry attractiveness consists of certain factors which is prevailing in the industry concern, which affect profitability of the organization either favorably or unfavorably. And industry attractiveness is determined by certain factors, that is nature of demand, industry profit potential, profit potential, and last is what? Entry and the exit barrier. Now, these four factors we have to explain one by one, that is nature of the industry, then industry potential, profit potential, and the exit and entry barrier, or entry and exit barrier. Clear? Now, first is nature of the demand. Now, the analysis of demand gives the scope of its present and the future business. And when the organization analyzes the demand of the product, gives an area, gives and scope of the present and the future business. Now, if the industry demand is increasing because of certain factors like increase in population, increase in the income, then we can say industry becomes attractiveness. Example, fast food industry, retail industry, it comes under what? Industry attractiveness. Because industry demand is increasing because of what? Increase in the population, increase in income of the consumer. So, industry becomes attractiveness. And just opposite, if the demand is decreasing, either because of industry being at a declining life cycle stage or because of the substitute products, it is not attractive. So, example, MP3 players industry, landline phone industry, okay, it comes under declining life cycle stage. So, it is what? It is not attractive industry. So, industry attractiveness or not, we can determine on the basis of the nature of the demand. Then, second is industry potential. Now, industry potential again deals with the scope of the business that it offers at present and in future. That is, industry potential depends on total industry sales potential. Industry potential is mainly depends on what? Industry potential mainly deals with the industry sale potential, selling coupon. Okay, that means high volume industry has much more potential than low volume industry, because high volume industry can accommodate large number of players and capturing large market share push the sales at higher level. Best example, in the case of oral care industry, toothpaste can be considered as what? High volume industry. But that is not the case with the tooth powder segment. Okay, so industry potential aap kise determine karoge? It depends upon the total industry ka sales potential. In industry mein kitna sales hai, industry sales potential. Now we all know that ki jo industries ka high selling hai, that is high volume industries hai, has much more potential as compared to the low volume industry. Because jo high volume industries hai, uske large number of jo high volume industries hai, can accommodate large number of the players, and it capturing the large market share, which ultimately push the sales at a higher level. Clear? So, हम लोग ने यहाँ पे example लिया कि oral care industry में toothpaste जो segment है, toothpaste वो high volume industry में आता है, but it is not case of the tooth powder segment. Okay? Then third is profit potential. Now, profit potential is related to the existence of possibility of earning targeted volume of profits. It depends on what? It depends on possibility of the earnings. Possibility of earnings targeted volume of profits. Yeah. Now, though profit volume is related to the sales volume and both move together, but it is the rate of profitability that matters. Okay. That means जो इंडस्ट्री का सेल्स वॉल्यूम बढ़ेगा, सेल्स वॉल्यूम बढ़ेगा तो प्रॉफिट वॉल्यूम भी क्या होगा, बढ़ेगा. यानी बोथ मूव इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. बट मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज व्हाट, मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज रेट ऑफ प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी. यानी रेट ऑफ प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी इज व्हाट मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. सो जनरली जो नॉलेज बेस्ड इंडस्ट्रीज है लाइक कंसल्टेंसी, आईटी सर्विसेज, it offer higher profitability, and the industries where the product differentiation exist, it offer higher profitability as compared to the commodity industry. Clear? So industry attractiveness or not, it again determine on the basis of profit potential. So jo knowledge based industries hai, like consultancy service, IT services, it offer higher profitability. And जो इंडस्ट्री में प्रोडक्ट डिफरेंशिएशन है वो उसमें भी हायर प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी है एज कंपेयर टू द कॉमोडिटी इंडस्ट्री. क्लियर? एंड लास्ट इज व्हाट, एंट्री एंड एग्जिट बैरियर. नाउ एवरी इंडस्ट्री हैज सम एंट्री बैरियर टू द न्यू कमर्स और द न्यू एंट्रेंट एंड एग्जिट बैरियर टू द एग्जिस्टिंग प्लेयर्स. नाउ देयर मे बी नंबर ऑफ एंट्री बैरियर सच एज इकोनॉमी ऑफ स्केल ऑफ ऑपरेशन. ना इकोनॉमी ऑफ स्केल ऑफ ऑपरेशन मतलब लार्ज स्केल प्रोडक्शन विच लीड्स टू वॉट, कॉस्ट पर यूनिट ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग द प्रोडक्ट बिकम लेसर एंड लेसर विच इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर द न्यू एंट्रेंट. ओके. सो इकोनॉमी ऑफ स्केल इट एक्ट एज अ एंट्री बैरियर फॉर द न्यू कमर्स. देन इन्वेस्टमेंट रिक्वायरमेंट, एंड इन सम ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री वेरी हाई लेवल ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट it ultimately act as an entry barrier for the newcomers. And the degree of product differentiation, and jo firm ka product it is much more differentiated, so it develop the high brand loyalty in the mind of the customer, so again it act as an entry barrier for the newcomers. So these are some of the entry barrier for the newcomers, that is what entry barrier for the newcomers. Likewise there may be some exit barrier also for the existing competitors. Okay. Best example, if a company exit from the industry, it has to pay some cost which will depends on the desirability of putting the existing production facility to the alternative uses. If this feasibility is low, then cost of exit will be high. Yani koi organization industry ko leave karna chahti hai to uske liye exit barrier hai. Which type of exit barrier? It has to pay some cost which will depends on desirability of putting the existing production facility to the alternative uses. Okay. And suppose textile businesses mein declining ja raha hai, to usko pharmaceutical mein jana hai. So textile businesses ka jo bhi assets hai usko kya karna hai, that is desirability of putting the existing production facilities to the alternative uses. अगर वो फिजिबिलिटी लो हुआ, पॉसिबल नहीं हुआ, देन द कॉस्ट ऑफ एग्जिट विल बी हाई. दैट इज़ व्हाट एंट्री एंड द एग्जिट बैरियर. ओके. सो इंडस्ट्री अट्रैक्टिवनेस कैन बी डिटरमाइंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ नेचर ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री, नेचर ऑफ द डिमांड, इंडस्ट्री पोटेंशियल. नाउ नेचर ऑफ डिमांड इज व्हाट, डिमांड इज हाई और डिमांड इज लो. देन इंडस्ट्री पोटेंशियल इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द इंडस्ट्री का सेल्स पोटेंशियल. Then profit potential, and last is what, entry and the exit barrier. Clear? Now last part D, that is industry performance. Now industry performance is related to the current and the future factors which determine performance of the industry. Okay. And the performance of the industry, it is generally measured in terms of certain factors, that is profitability, operational efficiency, innovation in the technological advancement. Okay. In industry ka performance, it is measured in terms of these four factors: profitability, operational efficiency, innovation and the technological advancement. So first is what, profitability. Now, industry performance, it is generally measured in terms of the profitability, either related to sales or investment. Okay, आपको किसमें measure करना है profitability? Either related to sales and the investment. Though both these move in the same direction in the industry, but this may give contrasting conclusion if two or more industries are compared. Okay, take an example. Now, ये आपको समझ में आना sales and investment और profitability with the sales and profitability with the investment. Both move in the same direction in the industry. But this may give opposite result, that is contrasting conclusion if two or more industries are compared. Say example, highly capital intensive industry. Say example, oil and natural gas commission वगैरह. Okay, so highly capital intensive industry may show high profitability in relation to sales as compared to the low capital intensive industries. Example, commodity industry. Okay, so high capital intensive industry है ना, it show the high profitability in relation to sales. ने sales कम होगा ना, तो भी वो लोग का profitability ज़्यादा दिखेगा as compared to the low capital intensive industry. But this situation may change if the profitability is related to the total investment. Okay, because high capital intensive है ना, तो उसमें investment भी बहुत high रहता है. Okay, so उसके comparison में उसका profitability कम दिखेगा. Whereas जो low capital intensive industries है ना, उसका investment कम होगा, तो profitability बढ़ जाएगा. Okay, so profitability is related to total investment. Therefore, we have to consider both parameters, that is sales as well as investment. Clear? This is what profitability. Then next is what operational efficiency. Now, operational efficiency generally described input-output relationship, that is what amount of output is achieved by using given amount of inputs. Okay, so operational efficiency. Now, efficiency always measure in terms of what? Input-output relationship. It is measured in terms of what? Input-output relationship. Yaane, kitna output achieve karna hai, kitna output produce karna hai by using given amount of inputs. That means if we take less amount of inputs and we produce more amount of output, then we can say the productional facility is what? Efficient. But aap zyada input lete ho aur output kam produce ho raha hai, then we can say the product is what? Inefficient. Okay, now the operational efficiency depends on certain factors, that is manpower productivity, level of technology, raw materials quality and availability and so on. And we all know that in India, operational efficiency in automated technology industry, it is much more higher as compared to semi-automated or the manual technology. Okay, this is what operational efficiency. Then next is what innovation. Now, what is innovation? You already know, or we all know that what is innovation. Innovation refers to what? Any product or any idea that is perceived by someone as new. Okay, मुझे लगा ये product नया है, so I perceived this is what innovation. So innovation is what? Any product or any idea that is perceived by someone as new. Now, in some industry, rate of innovation is higher as compared to the others. Now, such an innovation may be in the form of adding more features in the product or introduction of different marketing channels and so on. Okay, so हम लोग को पता है कि जो electronic industries है, जहाँ पे innovation, rate of innovation, it is much more higher as compared to the commodity industry or as compared to the sugar, industry, and that is what commodity industry. Okay, and these innovations may be in the form of adding more features in the existing product or introduction of certain different marketing channels and so on. That is what innovation. And next is technological advancement. Now, technological advancement is mainly concerned with what? rate of development of new technology and their adoption in creation of the product and services. Okay, now high rate of technological development in an industry creates entry barrier, and it also affects the existing competitive equilibrium in the industry, as a company with new technology has enormous competitive advantage in the form of cost and the product features. Okay, so we take an example of introduction of a four-stroke engine in two-wheelers has created several advantage over two-stroke engine. Okay, so technological advance means what? Rate of development of new technology. Now जैसे नया टेक्नोलॉजी डेवलप्ड हुआ वो टेक्नोलॉजीज को कैसे अडॉप्ट करना है इन द क्रिएशन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट एंड सर्विसेज. एंड वी ऑल नो दैट कि हाई रेट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट इन एन इंडस्ट्री क्रिएट एंट्री बैरियर फॉर द न्यू कमर्स. ओके, बिकॉज इमीडिएट हाई लेवल ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी को अडॉप्ट करना हर एक के पास रिसोर्सेज इतना अवेलेबल नहीं रहता है. सो हाई रेट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट इट एक्ट एज अ एंट्री बैरियर फॉर द न्यू कमर्स. ओके, एंड जैसे नया नया टेक्नोलॉजी आता जाएगा इट अल्टीमेटली अफेक्ट द एग्जिस्टिंग कम्पिटिटिव इक्विलिब्रियम, बिकॉज जो कंपनी के पास न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी है वो सर्टन कम्पिटिटिव एडवांटेज अचीव कर सकता है इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कॉस्ट एंड द प्रोडक्ट फीचर्स. ओके, सो हम लोग ने यहाँ पे एग्जाम्पल लिया कि फोर स्ट्रोक इंजिन का इनोवेशन हुआ, इंट्रोडक्शन हुआ इन टू व्हीलर्स हैज क्रिएटेड सेवरल एडवांटेज एज कम्पेयर टू द टू स्ट्रोक इंजिन. क्लियर? सो दिस इज कॉल्ड इज वॉट इंडस्ट्री परफॉर्मेंस. सो इंडस्ट्री परफॉर्मेंस इज बेसिकली रिलेटेड विथ सर्टन फैक्टर्स विच डिटरमाइन द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री. द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ इंडस्ट्री कैन बी मेजर इन टर्म्स ऑफ फोर फैक्टर्स, दैट इज प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी, ऑपरेशनल एफिशिएंसी, इनोवेशंस एंड द टेक्नोलॉजिकल एडवांसमेंट. क्लियर? सो हियर वी कंप्लीटेड फर्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज इंडस्ट्री एनालिसिस. और वो इंडस्ट्री एनालिसिस में मेजर फोर फैक्टर्स, दैट इज इंडस्ट्री सेटिंग, इंडस्ट्री स्ट्रक्चर, इंडस्ट्री अट्रैक्टिवनेस एंड द इंडस्ट्री परफॉर्मेंस. नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन we will discuss about the competitor analysis, very 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 important topic, that is competitor analysis. Bye.